First of all, is Congresswoman Black and Ms. Blackburn still here? Okay, I wanted to thank them because they helped pass the budget for our military that has been gutted for the past several decades. And I fly a 1957 aircraft into combat, and some of our enlisted live below the poverty level. So it was absolutely essential that they pass that budget, and I really appreciated that. So I'm Ashley, and I'm a little late to the race. I appreciate being here tonight. I missed Raul's Lincoln Day celebration because I was deployed. I just recently got back from the Middle East. I serve in the U.S. Air Force and the Air National Guard as a combat aviator. And so I'm sorry I missed that day, but I was actually flying a mission over Afghanistan at that time. So I live my life by faith, family, and service. And that's what I like to concentrate on. And many people ask me, as a mother of four and as a military pilot, a husband who I've been together with for 19 years now, I'm blessed to have as my better half, why I would consider running. And I like to focus on that why. And that why is because we need someone who believes in what our nation stands for. My grandfather was a combat aviator too. He died in 1945 after flying missions through the whole war, and his grave is at the bottom of the Pacific. They knew halfway through their mission that they would not make it back, that they would run out of fuel, but they knew that what they were doing was so essential that they elected to continue. He believed in the greater good. He died 2 months before my mother was born. There were three survivors on that aircraft, so I do know the story. But he believed in that good. And when I fly into the when I get into the cockpit of my aircraft in the desert and it's 140 degrees and I'm sweating and I've deployed for my family multiple times, I have to believe in the greater good. I have to know why we're going. Why I'm carrying over 150,000 pounds of fuel over the combat zone. And it's to protect those men and women on the ground, and it's to make sure that we continue the greater good. I want to take that greater good to Washington, because I feel so many people have forgotten what they were sent there to do. They are our public servants. They are supposed to be our voice. They are supposed to believe in what they are sent there to do. And they need to stand up for what our voices are saying. So many times they get up there and they forget that. And they worry about being reelected. And they worry about staying up there. I want to go up there on a new mission. And I'm asking you to send me on that mission to shake Washington up, to bring a new voice. We have to work on our immigration. Yes, as a mother of five children, does it hurt to see those men, those women that are separated from their children? Of course it does. But they entered into our country knowing they were breaking the law. I would not put my children in that same place. We have to enforce our immigration policy. Too many administrations have kicked that can down the road. It's time for us to look at it, change it, and make sure that it's implemented. Our health care, it's been gutted also. My husband serves at the University of Tennessee as a professor of surgery and as a trauma surgeon in critical care. We've seen how the Affordable Care Act has gutted health care, how it's affected small businesses, and how it's hurt the very class it was supposed to help, and that's the middle class. We need to look at health care and change it and give power back into the hands of the people to decide what health care they want, what doctors they can see, and how the doctors treat individuals. I also believe strongly in term limits, because I think that's how we really change Washington. We need new voices in there. We need people who are concerned about completing the mission and getting it done, rather than building their kingdoms and staying up there and forgetting why we sent them. I don't mean to keep it long. I'll keep it a little shorter, like Mr. Burchett. He always makes it short and sweet, and I always appreciate that. But remember the greater good. When you go in to vote, I ask for your vote, and I ask for your voice, and I also ask for your prayers, because there are people over there right now who are putting their life on the line, And as all of you know here, because you wouldn't be here if you didn't believe in the same things. You know that blanket of freedom that you sleep under? It's not free. And this is the shining city upon a hill. This country is great. And it's time to make sure that it is great again. And we can do it together with our voices. Thank you. And y'all, pray for the troops before you go to bed tonight. Because it is America, and God bless it.